hit the board. Auspicious activities when moon is transiting in this nakshatra, or when your ninth lord is transiting this nakshatra, then you can start your research in occult studies. You can do meditation. If your 12th lord is moving through this nakshatra, it's a good time for travel. If moon is moving through this nakshatra, or your 12th lord, 8th lord, because it's about crossing the oceans, you want to move into a pilgrimage. Okay, so you can have the 9th lord moving over this nakshatra. You will be going on a number of trips and pilgrimages.
Okay.
We do not just write, you know, we do not just write that this thing happens. We need to have a practical association as to why these things are happening, how these things are happening, how they would be activated. Finance and accounting. Why so? Because this nakshatra is associated again with Mitra and Saraswati. So this thing is very accepted. This thing is something that comes up very well. Secretive activities, well, I'll give it Scorpio. These people also Mitra again. Yeah, again, I told you that Mitra does not get people. They're very affable. These people are very lovable, but they maintain their own inner core. What's going within them, very few will have a preview to it. Entertainment. Very affable, very loving, very jovial, very loved by others. If your 9th lord, if your 10th lord is posited in this nakshatra, you can also take up, you know, stand-up comedy is catching very fast, you know, in as a, one of the professions, coming up professions. It's also one part that you can take up. In fact, Akshay Kumar is also known, apart from his, you know, when I come back to that, Akshay Kumar is also known as being a very strong comedian. He is Golmaal, his series of
Hera-Feri also.
Oh Baby, Hera-Feri, all these movies are very well known for, you know, the, its timing, comedic timing. Healing is one very, very strong aspect of this nakshatra. And anytime that a person, this is something going on, you can... when moon moves over this nakshatra, healing becomes very easy. Immigration. Many people apply for immigrations. When you apply at the time of this nakshatra functioning, moon moving there, your 9th lord moving there, the 8th lord is because of crossing of oceans, your 12th lord, you can be very happily safe. Okay, I'll get through the immigrations.
Wow, that's great.
Okay, Beej Mantras. So when we move on to the Beej Mantras, we see that there's, I will move ahead with the mantras with a lot of disclaimer. Until and unless you are initiated into the mantras by a proper guru, do not do the Beej Mantras at all. Or the Gayatri Mantra. Because they are very, very potent.
Yes.
You do not know how to do it, and they, you will have a lot of side effects if you're not taking the help of somebody very, very learned, very wise, and knower of these mantras. Om Yam, Om Ram, 108 times. Om Indra, you know, it's the Gayatri mantra. So I would not, without taking, you have to follow certain rules with the Gayatri mantra also. Very, very important.
Yeah, that is why even when I do live sessions, people are asking me, oh, my Saturn is in the third house, what mantra I should chant? I'm like, I don't know. The first thing, I don't know your whole life, nor do I know your horoscope. How can I suggest you just from one placement? That's not possible.
This is just not done. You, for remedials, there are very different methods. For remedials, there are different methods. One need, in fact, if the you look at a Prashna chart and while giving a remedial, and if that remedial is not this time to happen to a person, you don't give.
Oh.
There are certain astrologers who do not give remedial measures at all.
Oh. And one more thing I wanted to ask you regarding this nakshatra. Sometimes I get questions that, oh, my marriage is finalized when moon is in Anuradha, or should we finalize it then? So what is your opinion on marriage dates and weddings on this nakshatra?
See, generally you have when Sun is transiting through this house post Diwali, you have marriage season is on.
Okay, so when Moon is there, then also this can happen. So that's not a issue. Okay.
I don't think so. Okay. Honestly, because marriage is not an issue with this nakshatra. I don't think so.
Okay, I see.
But depends again, as we have discussed earlier. Okay, as we had discussed earlier, depends on the pada the moon would fall in, where it would. So nowadays people don't, bother much about murta or things like that, or they get a murta, they're happy with it, but they do not follow the time essence. Murta is very important to be followed. If you're doing something and if you've not taken out the murta, no worries at all. Then you go with the flow. But if you've put a murta for a thing to happen, go with the murta, because murta is helping you move in synchronicity with time.
Okay. Yes.
If you're not following that murta, the moon moves into a different nakshatra, and then you would say that yes, we had a murta then, but it didn't work. But you are the one who did not follow the timing properly.
Yes.
So why in the first place create problems for yourself and then blame astrology also? If you have a murta to put, do that, and then follow it strictly. If you're not putting, no issues. Go with the flow and let the divine take its, way.
Yes, yes.
Okay, Vishnu says now, all of us are, all of us can do one remedy, which is absolutely gives you a lot of protection. And I know of people who have done Vishnu Sahasranam, their life and their ending has been so smooth that I envy their ending.
Okay.
So Vishnu Sahasranam, I personally believe, is one of those very big, not very big, but one of those stotrams, the pujas, the sahasranams that one should practice on a regular basis. For people who want to learn nakshatras, it's very important. Now, every nakshatra, Vishnu Sahasranam has 108 padas. Okay.
Yes.
And every one pada resonates to one pada of the nakshatras. 27 nakshatras into 4 will give you 108. So, as you move, say if you are born in Bharani, third pada. So the seventh pada of Vishnu Sahasranam is something that you should recite every day, 7 times, or 7 into 3 times, as 7 into 2 times, that is 14, because it's the second nakshatra, whichever number of times that you want to, but you should. That will give you a lot of protection.
Mm-hmm.
So this is Anuradha first, second, third and fourth pada that is associated with the Vishnu Sahasranam.
So suppose somebody has Anuradha moon or any planet, suppose in Anuradha 2, then what do you say that they should be chanting?
Yes.
Oh, this is amazing.
It's basically to do with placement of moon. Say, my Janma Rashi is, say, supposing Magha, third pada. Then, 9 fours are 36, 37, 38, 39, 40th. As I said, Magha, fourth pada. So, 40th pada of Vishnu Sahasranam is something that I should be chanting every day.
Okay.
If I do not do the entire Vishnu Sahasranam, but at least this much I should be doing.
Yes.
Okay. So now remedial measures. Yeah, the combination has to be that of Mars and Saturn. Okay. So you can also give, because. One, as I told you, this 12 Surya Namaskars that one does is a very empowering thing. So if you do the Surya Namaskar right in the first hora, and I mean the first hora, So when you're doing with the rising sun, then this gives you a lot of empowerment. Like nothing. This kills a lot of diseases, kills a lot of problems in your life. For those who want, they can always check it out. It's there as the 12 Namaskars, Surya Namaskar mantras. It's very, very beautiful. And you see the first one taking the slot there is Om Mitraya Namah.
Yes.
And it's a frustration to him who is affectionate to all. He's affectionate and lovable to all. So other remedial measures would include your Mars and Saturn combination also, because Saturn is the Lagna, is the lord of this nakshatra, placed in the house of Mars. So somebody, and again, this nakshatra gives you a technicality. These people are very technical oriented people because of the Mars and Saturn connection. Somebody who helps a young child in learning. See, because helping is what Saturn is good at. Child, Kumar, a young man, you know, helping a young warrior, a young man in his profession, in his job, giving red seeds, pomegranate seeds to a needy on a Saturday. Okay. Giving donations on a Saturday to somebody who is needy. And at the same time, say like Kumar, he's a warrior, but he's wanted, but he will not ask you for it. So if you go ahead and give it to him, then it's good. Doing service to people who are, you know, in hospitals having blood cancer or something like that, because again, the relationship of Saturn and Mars coming into.
Okay.
But these you have to correlate your house, or you know, remedial measures should not be given very prototype. They have to be individualistic, because the chart has to say which lord, which planet, which house, everything getting afflicted, and then you work it out through prashna, basically. Finally, we come to god of this nakshatra. The goddess of this nakshatra is goddess as per the, you know, as in Tamil, there is the contact details that you have, and all this is happening in Tamil. You can call up these people, but Ulganayaki, as she is known in Tamil, she is supposed to be the goddess of this nakshatra. We hold on Saraswati and Mitra, but they have their own temples. These nakshatras, the 27 temples in India. So if you want to have an affliction which is removed, as they say, you can go there. This is a disclaimer. That, yes.
No. Carry on.
So I think you wanted to ask something. So this is a disclaimer that not that we are propagating, but these temples of the nakshatras exist, and a person can go there and, you know, do the necessary prayers and feel a little relief from the afflictions.
Oh, I didn't know that there are temples specific to like this nakshatras also.
Yes, there are, you know. So that brings me to the end of what I had to impart about this nakshatra. Any questions from your side, Babaji?
No, as of now, I don't have any question. But I'm very sure when people are watching this, then they're going to have tons of questions for you. So I would say that you can ask and she will reply whenever she has time, she will definitely reply to it. And please go and subscribe to her channel, because there you will find all the videos that you want. And ma'am, you also said something coming up regarding your course. So if you could just say some details so that they can also decide if they want.
I'm planning a course in Nakshatra from, you know, June coming ahead. I plan to take up a course in Nakshatras, because this is something that I am very familiar with, having taught it. And it is the first level and the second level. The first level consists of the first 9 Nakshatras, and the second level consists of the second set of 9 Nakshatras. From Mula to your Jyeshtha. The first 9 nakshatras would be from Ashwini to Ashlesha, and then I have 2 sets coming up.
Okay, and if they want a consultation from you, I'm very sure they will now want to know my nakshatra is here or there. So,
okay. So you can go to my website www.anuradhasharda.com,
okay.
And there are three consultations, type of consultations available. You can check them out and you can come back to me on that. I would definitely be able to help you. Try to help you as best as I can.
Yeah, fantastic.
Thank you so much, Balaji, for inviting me.
Yeah, I'll be inviting you again and again because you have to keep coming. And let me see which nakshatra my subscribers want you to speak the next. So I will see whatever they write in the comments. Maybe it is another nakshatra of Saturn. Thank you very much.
Love
yeah, thank you very
thank
much.
You so much.
Yeah, see
thank
you next time.